IMpower150 was a critical trial that included patients who were eligible for angiogenesis inhibition, and also included, in distinction from the 024 and 042 trials with Pembro single agent and the KEYNOTE-189 trial, it included individuals with molecular aberrations. So this was essentially a non-squamous trial. Since patients had to be eligible for bevacizumab, the control arm, C, looked at PAC-carbo bevacizumab, the 4599 regimen that actually led to bevacizumab's approval. And the two experimental arms looked at PAC-carbo combined with atezolizumab, so a direct one-for-one comparison between atezo and bev. And arm B was actually a quadruplet, so 4599 with atezo added to that, PAC, carbo, bev, and atezo. It's a huge trial. Over 1,200 patients were accrued. The primary analysis was arm B versus C, so the question of whether atezo actually added to PAC, carbo, bev, and in fact it did. We see an improvement in overall response rate in the mid-60 range versus about 46-48%. We see a major improvement in progression-free survival. The medians aren't that much different, maybe a two-month advantage of the median, but what's intriguing is that the curves separate increasingly over time, and that speaks to a potential synergy that may exist between bevacizumab and the checkpoint inhibitor, atezolizumab. Angiogenesis inhibitors can upregulate VEGF, can cause other issues with T cell suppressors, cells that are potentially inhibited by checkpoint inhibition. So there may be real synergy occurring. At the ASCO 2018, the final formal survival results are being reported. And in fact, we see a 4.5 to 5 month improvement in median survival from the mid 14 month range to 19 and a half months. This is quite remarkable. The control group performed at least as well as it had performed in the ECOG 4599 trial, the adenocarcinoma group. The benefit extends and in fact is even more pronounced in those with EGFR mutations or ALK translocations. The control group has a median survival of about 17 months. It's not even reached in the atezo arm. And we see it in the opposite end of the spectrum. In patients with visceral dominant disease, such as liver metastases, the numbers are lower, but the degree of survival benefit is just as pronounced, 13 and a half months versus 9 months or so. So the trial is really unprecedented. We have never seen any other agents added to the 4599 regimen improve outcome as we have here. And this regimen potentially becomes our go-to regimen in patients who have oncogenic drivers whose disease is really becoming TKI refractory. The final common pathway for all of our patients with EGFR mutation or ALK translocation or ROS1 or any of the other major drivers remains chemotherapy. Eventually, the TKIs no longer work.
IMpower150 used several strategies to evaluate for enrichment in terms of benefit from this therapy. So beyond PD-L1 expression, there was a T effector signature that was explored that contained three genes. And there was also a subgroup analysis for patients who presented with liver metastasis. There was benefit associated with high PD-L1 expression, as well as high T effector signature. And there was also benefit for patients with liver metastasis. And that is actually information that is important because liver metastases are thought to represent immunosuppressive tumor microenvironment, and therefore the improvements that we saw in patients' progression-free survival in the setting of liver metastases are a very positive signal.